Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Boone coming at you all with a brand new Supreme drop list review. Why do I have so much energy for such a dull ass drop list? That's a good question. My boy Draco the Ruler just got freed from jail. That is crazy, man. I'm sure like none of you really know who that dude is, but you guys probably know by now my outro music's by O3 Greedo. Draco is pretty much one of his like good homies, a guy he works with hella in music, who's been locked up super wrongfully for several years at this point. He just got freed today, so that news has me in such a good mood. If you guys fuck with Draco, go drop a comment, free Draco, let's go. But let's get into this drop list, boys. Drop a like if you do enjoy the video. Thank you to everyone for the love on my room tour video yesterday. Expect this apartment tour video. I was actually trying to use a different cord for my light yesterday and shit started smoking, so that's not good at all. I'll stop delaying. We only have so much time. It's Wednesday. We're a little bit late with this video, so let's get into it. I hope you guys enjoy. I almost forgot. We're doing a giveaway on browser. First off, you guys gotta peep this motherfucking turkey with that browser logo snapping. I don't know who does the logo game better, but we're doing a giveaway with Koi Solutions. If you guys want to go join that, it's basically for you botter boys or anyone looking to get a bot. Go join the giveaway, get it for free, maybe get a browser membership. But drop list talk, let's go. So we finally have the Nike Air Max releasing. Maybe I clickbaited this video like crazy Nike sneaker release, like it's honestly, these are not my favorite. I talked about this Nike collab before. The white pair is just so dull to me. I feel like the black pair is 10 times better. And I actually saw a photo. These hoes glow in the dark, which I don't know why I'm like excited over a shoe glowing in the dark. I'm not six anymore, but I am. The red pair is still king, but the white pair is very wearable, pretty clean. We got that little Supreme spell out, little red swoosh and accents. I guess the little box logo is nice on the tongue. I don't think these are gonna resell though, so we're not gonna talk too much about these. Definitely a good shoe for the personal. Try to get free shipping if you go for it. There's a lot of items you can multi-cart with these. Maybe a case, maybe a keychain, a beanie. So I don't really expect these to sell for too much money, but not a bad personal. Oh man, dude, I don't even know where to begin with this. So we got the Supreme iPhone case. This is probably something a lot of you have waited on for a while because Supreme's never really done a traditional iPhone case. They've done the Mophie chargers, which technically counts, but it's not just like a normal ass case. These though, man, look like they are fresh off of Amazon. Someone in my Discord said these look like they came from a mall kiosk. Like, come on, bro. These are definitely pretty mid in my opinion, and the fact it's only for an iPhone 11, which is soon gonna be outdated with the new iPhone coming out, it's just typical Supreme being behind on the trends, being incredibly late. Personally, I feel like in the year 2020, people don't really want a Supreme iPhone case. However, I mean, it's not the worst design, I suppose. There's way better stuff they could have chosen, but we do got the camo. I will say, I don't know much about phones. It says it's available for 11, 11 Pro, 11 Pro Max. I don't know if you're gonna be able to choose those sizes on the website or if all of those are the same size. I have an iPhone 11, so I know you guys want to see me cop this. It's not gonna happen, so stop wishing for that. Like, I mean, I'll buy one, raffle it on Seattle Select. Hey, go follow me. But I certainly will not put this on my phone. As you guys see, I have no phone case, and it's gonna stay that way. I'd rather bust the shit out of my phone than let someone see me pull out this Four Loko Supreme camo case. It's just not for me. The pink color is definitely gonna do the best. I will say, the pink camo is kind of delicious. Like, I can't even hate on it. Other colors, very dull. The blue's not bad, man. Actually, the blue's kind of clean. Pink's good for your lady. Besides that, I don't know how these are gonna do. I mean, it's 36. They're definitely gonna resell. I don't think they're gonna go for as crazy amounts some people might think. I'd guess around 50 to 60 bucks. It's such bad timing. There's a new iPhone coming out right when they drop this. Like, what are you doing, Supreme? Honer keychain. This is pretty much the same thing as the Melodica. Well, it's made by the same company. This is a harmonica. Pretty much a broke boy melodica, because let's not beat around the bush, man. The melodica shits on it. Wait, what is this whole ass handcuff, bro? Like, this is the weirdest like connector I've seen for a keychain. But the actual like harmonica itself is pretty cool, I'm not gonna lie. The little details on it with the gold embellishment, actually kind of nice. Now, harmonicas are the most obnoxious instrument besides maybe ukuleles. Actually, freshman year at Gonzaga, my roommate had a harmonica, and it's partially the reason I dropped out. Like, I don't want to relive those days. Holy shit. So, will I go for this? I don't want to, but it's my job to buy stupid shit on this website. Yes, I'm gonna go cart one of these. Definitely like a good multi-cart item. Honestly, the musical instruments from Supreme traditionally do pretty well, so I could actually see this having some resale, 50, maybe 60 bucks, and it's definitely like a nice item. Like, the design of it's really cool. And 32, I don't feel like it's too bad of a deal. Like, they have plastic keychains for almost the same price. So yeah, I'm gonna grab one of these. I actually think it could kind of be a sleeper item, but let's keep it moving. We got the hooded down jacket. I just don't like these. I'm not a fan. I mean, the whole like receipts little print is funny. It's clever. IKEA Off-White did it first, but I don't know. I'm not gonna be buying it or anything. It's gonna be what, like $2 billion? $358, not the worst. I mean, it's probably so cozy. This shit, it's gotta be a whole ass pillow. The pink might be nice for your lady. I wonder if we can see what dude's caught. You can't even see. I really wanna see what is on these receipts. My prediction is it's a checkout of every single tire tee and every single color, size, medium. But yeah, who knows? It's not gonna resell. It's a decent design, but not for me. Moving on, woven label beanie. So these are actually pretty cool. We have the Everlast logo brought back yet again. Supreme's definitely been bringing back this logo a lot recently. Supreme Everlast is definitely a very popular collaboration. They did the punching bag, the boxing gloves. They did like that crew neck. I think they've even done other clothing items. So this is definitely like a nice little piece. I like the colors they chose actually. Like, they're pretty nice. I don't even gotta tell you guys what color to go for. You already know the drill, black color. Also, this pink's not too bad, but those are the two. Actually, you know what? This is a little like tannish brown. There's a lot of actually pretty tasteful colors. The white's the only one I would really miss out on. Can't really go wrong though, man. Like, woven label, that sounds hella nice. That sounds good quality. 34 bucks. I'm not sleeping. I recommend you guys don't either. Definitely some money to be made. Moving on, the all white Air Max hat. No, like, this thing is terrible, bro. No, it's not gonna resell. Woven label long sleeve top. These are only 68. Okay, you know what? I'm actually pretty impressed. I would have expected them to be more. I do way prefer the beanie, but there actually is some potential for I didn't even realize this was 68 till now. Black color XL, like, I could actually see that being a decent item to grab. I wouldn't really recommend it, but like, to get to a free shipping maybe, XL black, you could definitely make your money back, if not some profit on top. The fact that it's not like screen printed or anything actually helps it out, so not a bad item, but I'm not gonna give it the stamp of resell approval. Moving on, we have this horrendous, I hate this design, dude. I don't know why, but just bothers me. Yeah, we got the crew necks. Crew necks don't sell. Like, they just, nobody wants a crew neck. I mean, I like crew necks, but they just don't do well for Supreme. 148 for a crew neck is ridiculous. So let's keep it moving. Windstopper small box ear flap six panel. Jesus Christ, that's a long name. This, oh, Gore Windstopper, okay. These look like they're probably pretty high quality. The Cordura mini box logo hat that released last season, I was telling people to go pick up, and those are actually doing really well on the market. I sold mine on Seattle Select for around 120, 130, and that's what they're at. This will still do well. It's certainly not gonna do as well as the first hat. It having ear flaps makes it only appropriate for fall winter, which actually hurts it. I mean, I guess you could cut them off, but why would you do that, bro? This is your opportunity to look like me. Like, I got permanent ear flaps on body at all times. And yes, sir, these are some Windstopper too. They're also some pussy stoppers because nobody will touch me. These are dope though. I actually like do enjoy them. I'm not gonna buy one because I don't like box logo shit like this, but it's not a bad item for winter. Black, of course, I don't gotta tell you guys this. Green's also a good option. Pink is sus. Red and white, I don't even really have much faith in. Wait, what's retail for these? They're 58. Yeah, I would say black and green are definitely what you should be targeting. Another really good item to get in a multi-cart. They shouldn't go too fast. Next up, Minecraft box logo long sleeve shits. No, I mean, hell no. I mean, to be fair, I could see maybe like, I don't even know, bro, actually. It is not too expensive. It's only, what, 58 bucks? I know you guys are sick of me saying this. A decent multi-card item. If you get, like, the right size XL, it probably could make you, like, 20 bucks or so, but I don't really recommend it. Dude. Okay, well, here comes the depressing part of this video. We got the Supreme Toshio Saeki. Stupid-ass retail, bro. 238. You're telling me I gotta drop 238 to look like a nympho, bro? This pimpin' ain't easy. Damn, dude, that's actually so disappointing to see. The retails for this collab are pretty through the roof, like ridiculous. So we have these like printed patches that were then woven onto the hoodie. That's the reason it's so expensive.
It really bums me out, man, because I do really enjoy these items. Like, the whole collab is really sick. They're some of my favorite items in the lookbook, and the colorway choices were so tasteful, bro. Like, they're so delicious. The olive, really nice. This, like, kind of plum color, I really enjoy. These could resell still, even though the retail is through the roof, man. Like, it's definitely a risk. Like, don't just buy this and think, oh yeah, bro, I just made hella money. Like, you are definitely taking a risk grabbing the hoodie. I'm more confident in the other two items. Although I think the hoodie's done better because, like, they did too many patches on the jacket and pants. It is just too much. I feel like the hoodie was a way more tasteful amount of patches. Some of my favorite patches are on the jacket and pants. We'll visit them in a sec. Next up, brush plaid sweater. Now this is an interesting one, man. These have potential to be one of the best resale items of the week, but what concerns me is the colorways are not the best, man. Now this white color is actually pretty nice. Normally though, white colorway items just don't do as well because obviously they get dirty more easily. I do like it. Like, this isn't really the color choice for me, but I really do see some good potential. I almost want to go grab one. The black color, I really don't like the colors they chose. I'm actually pretty disappointed because I would have loved to go grab one of these, man, if the colors had been right, but they just, they missed with the black colorway. The white color is not bad. The fact these are mohair is going to help them a lot. I told you guys on the cardigans, bro. I hyped up those cardigans all week. Was I wrong? Do I miss? No, sir. Go look at the resale prices. So again, this one I'm not as crazy confident on. The retail is muy bueno, 148. Like, how is a mohair sweater 148 and a crew neck is the same price? Is this shit even embroidered, bro? Okay, it is embroidered. I'll give you that. But like, that just makes no sense to me. The white color XL might not be a bad cook. You might even see me grab one of those. I'm undecided on what I'm gonna go for. I will be posting it in browser. I'll be telling you guys, go join. But moving on, we got a very clean one. I've actually never seen this before. The classic logo denim shirt. Nothing too crazy. We usually get one of these classic logo button-ups each season. Not a bad one. Like, what's retail? I don't know, it's gonna be gross as fuck. 120, all right, it's not the worst, but like 128 really. Just go thrift yourself a better button-up denim shirt than this, man. I don't really recommend it, obviously, for the personal. Oh God, dude, seeing that retail is pain, bro. I was talking to my Discord about it. I thought it was like false. When I first heard the retails for this shit, I was like, nah, y'all tripping, bro. There's no way it's that much. But yeah, $358, bro. Oh my God, dude. It's hard for me to even say there's gonna be resale on top of that, cause that is insane, man, and it bums me out cause this shit is so cool. We got little babies cutting off naked chicks' heads. Like, what could you not, like the tongue or some shit tied around this kid's, like, how can you not love it? Like, I can totally understand how you, like, this man is fucking a grandma, bro. Like, that's what I look for on my clothing. Is it worth $350 though? Maybe. There's, hey, it could be, nah, it's not, bro. Like, come on, son. We're about to go broke looking like we're fucking freaks. And it's really disappointing because this is definitely one of the better collabs of the season, at least in the lookbook that we saw. Man, it really actually bums me out a lot because I was totally planning on buying this stuff. There is potential it resells, but like with taxes and the crazy retail, I just don't see it being worth it, man. Like, you might be able to, I could be wrong. Honestly, these could end up being some like crazy resale item. Crazy as in like 50 to 100. That's crazy for Supreme nowadays. But it's such a risk, so much money. I gotta say it's a miss and it bums me out, man. Cause I really was ready to buy this shit. I don't know if I like the jacket or pants more. Okay, moving on, two-tone cinch pants. Actually a really good pickup. I've been hyping up the pants a lot lately. Feel like I haven't been wrong. I feel like they've been doing super well. Black pair right here is one of the cleaner pants of the season. I would almost keep these, but I have so many pants, bro. Hey, peep the new Johns though, bro. The Supreme is Love skate pants. Absolutely love these. Got them for like, I think 190 or so. These though, black pair, I'm giving them the certified stamp of resell approval. What are they, 128? That is a very tasty double cart. This brush sweater along with the pant, like that could make you some money, man. Smaller XL are usually the two best sizes for pants. I'll probably go for XL. Moving on, Alpine beanies. Somebody needs to call the office of Supreme. Just dial them up and be like, hey, guess what, James Jebbia? Nobody rocks pom-pom ass beanies with these fruity ass colors. Bro, like, how are you gonna waste this gorgeous little star emblem? I absolutely love this logo, even though it's fuck the cowboy. But I love this Supreme logo, and they just, Like, what is this beanie, bro? I like the colorways. No, the pom-pom on the dome. No, bro, like you need to check your homie if he has a pom-pom on his beanie. That's all I know. Y'all can clown me for the shit I wear like all day long, but at least I'm not rocking this shit. And I'm so sorry to the one person I'm targeting with this hate. I know one of you guys is gonna go cop this, and to be honest, I'm disappointed in you. Like, I truly am, bro. You could've, come on, son. You could've done something with your life and you decided to buy this shit. Moving on, we got a striped shirt. I cannot tell you the last time Supreme did a properly good striped shirt. Actually, I could. I don't remember the name of it. If I can remember the name of it, I'm gonna put it up on the screen right now. That was like the last time I remember Supreme actually doing a fucking striped shirt proper. Like, they've just been missing on this shit. I used to love my striped shit. Never wear it anymore. Definitely a miss. So next up, the pant. Damn, these pants are getting no love, man. These are almost at the bottom of the whole drop list. That's, y'all are foul for that, bro. You're upvoting the pom-pom beanie over this, like, pfft. All right, but these are actually, I prefer these, I think, over the jacket. Even though, like I was saying before, man, if they had just avoided half of these patches, I think these would have been so crazy hard. And the retail would have been cheaper. Like, it just would have been better for everyone. They definitely put too many patches on these. It's just too much, man. It's so loud. And it makes them more expensive, which pisses me off. But like, this patch is so hard, bro. So hard. They should have put this on a hoodie or something by itself. We obviously got the Naked Grandma, Bobby Hill, just the classic, man. I love the colored patches. Don't love the black and white. Like, if we just excluded all the black and white patches and just kept the colored ones, these would have been perfect. These just, I would have loved them. They would have came out so good. Disappointing, man. Supreme just always finds new ways to disappoint me. I would have gotten card declined anyways, or high traffic, whatever fucking stupid shit. Next up, snakeskin corduroy bell hat. Has anything snakeskin ever resold from Supreme? The box logo, that's it, bro. No, don't buy the. I mean, actually, they're kind of cool. I'm not gonna lie. They're not too bad. It would be gross, but these could somehow resell. I'm not gonna advise you guys to buy them, though. Definitely a huge risk, but actually not as bad as I'm hating on them for, but that's gonna do it. So, what I recommend, man, I'm not feeling the Air Maxes. I do think this keychain is worth grabbing. The iPhone cases probably will resell, so not a bad item. Beanie, like, if you really wanted to go smaller this week, beanie, iPhone, keychain, triple cart, not a bad one. I definitely think everyone should get a Windstopper. At least try to for black or green. Those are both gonna do well. Other colors, more of a gamble. Definitely the biggest gamble of the week is the Toshio Saeki items. They are fire, man. Like, I really enjoy them, but the retail is just too damn high. I think personally, I might grab one of these sweaters. I got faith in them, man. The mohair, it just doesn't lead me wrong usually. White color is pretty well done. I'm bummed though, because I would have loved one of these for the personal, but two-tone cinch pants. Honestly, y'all are gonna call this a dead week. That's cool, keep that energy. There is still some resellable items here. I think the two-tone cinch pants in black might be like my best item to grab that I really am confident are gonna do well on the market, but that's gonna do it for this video. It's Bitter Boy Boo Free Draco, baby, let's go. I hope you guys enjoyed. This video is fat, and god damn it, I did not wanna edit a fat video today, but I did it for the people. More videos on the way. FTP Live Cop, I know some of you guys have been asking me about that. I've had such issues with that stupid video, but I'm still gonna try to upload it on like Friday. I'm gonna spend several more hours dealing with the glitched ass video file. Keep an eye out for that video. We did go crazy on the site. I dropped like 1500. Kill me. But it's been your boy Boone. I'll see y'all in the next one. Supreme Life Cop tomorrow. I don't even look forward to this shit anymore. It's honestly just entering a torture chamber. I'll see y'all later though. It's been your boy Boone. I'm out. Peace.